Hola.
Buenas tardes. Bueno, para nosotros es un placer como Sadhana presentaros a Ashin Kelasa. Ashin Kelasa es monje de la tradición Theravada. Dentro del budismo es una familia bastante especial, ¿no? El budismo es como dos vías, Mahayana y Mayana, y hay una vía que es la Theravada, que es la que lleva la tradición transparente tal como la transmitió el Buda. Es decir, no está impregnada de otras culturas, de otras tradiciones, como pasa en el budismo tibetano, con el lamaísmo, en Japón con el sintoísmo, el budismo zen, sino es, entonces, tienen particularidades que a los que estamos alrededor nos encantan. Se levantan a las 3 de la mañana, empiezan a meditar, no paran, comen a las 8 y media de la mañana una vez al día, y luego ya se olvidan, ya no tienen problemas en todo el día. Lo difícil es adaptar todo eso a nuestro ritmo normal, ¿no? Pero se lo lleva muy relajado, se lo lleva muy bien, y sobre todo que yo creo que lo importante es la transmisión un poco en caliente, ¿no? En caliente de alguien que es la primera vez que sale de Birmania Occidente, que se va adaptando de una manera muy simple, de una manera tremendamente, no lo sé, amorosa, ¿no? Con relación a la gente, de una simplicidad total. No sé si queréis oír una clase magistral, es la clase de simpleza probablemente más bella que hay, ¿no? Y luego, dentro del proceso de él, una de las cuestiones, como es toda la enseñanza del budismo Theravada, se basa sobre todo en la práctica. Lo cual, como es nuestra intención siempre poner ese atento en la práctica, a mí me parece bellísimo que alguien transmita la práctica desde un sentimiento de que lo importante es que sea buena gente, ¿no? A todos los niveles. Y él va a poner la atención mucho en esos detalles de simplicidad, desde el budismo, lo que la teoría, la enseñanza, nos transmite como cosas muy simples, muy importantes, de las de llevarlas a lo diario, a lo cotidiano, ¿no? Y en ese sentido, para nosotros es un placer la convivencia con él. Es totalmente entrañable, amigable, y aunque le vemos como un personaje muy digno, porque lo lleva muy dignamente, pero para nosotros es una relación que se hace más de hermandad, de amistad. Y no os penséis que, aunque al principio da un poco de respeto porque los vemos un poco raros, pero luego le sucede lo mismo que a todos nosotros. Los mismos conflictos, los mismos problemas, y bueno, el diálogo se hace muy tremendamente fácil con él. Así que lo que pedimos de cara a la sala, la grabación, si la tenéis ahí a mano, la podéis hacer fotos, es lo que se pide de no hacer, porque si no, los clases es una para él que no está habituado, es como bastante distracción. Hay su acompañante, Miu, que es el que hace el vídeo y luego lo pondrá y lo pasaremos a todos tranquilamente. Y luego estará Eloisa, que estará haciendo fotos en la sala del grupo para evitar que haya cúmulo de detalles y de cositas. Y luego al final, no sé si sabéis, pero todo este movimiento lleva cargas enormes, y en vez de poner ni un precio, que tampoco nos apetecía porque no es fácil ponerlo, pusimos unas cestitas aquí afuera para que cada uno, en lo que sienta que nos aporte, que nos ayude, pedimos que no nos den sin monedas, porque luego no las tenemos que llevar, y eso pesa de verdad. Así que cada uno que haga la aportación desde donde quiera, como pueda y como le apetezca, y os lo agradeceremos enormemente como ayuda y apoyo a esta idea, que es simplemente como un sentido de Sadhana, ¿no? Yo pienso que Sadhana ha estado siempre buscando esa búsqueda del crecimiento personal, esa búsqueda simplemente de ser un poco mejores personas en lo que podamos, y yo creo que es un intento de todo el grupo de Sadhana, de que bueno, estas oportunidades que son las que son, de verdad, que no están mediatizadas por nada, sino son traídas, poderlos aportar y colaborar con ese sentimiento de todo el grupo de Sadhana, de poder hacer esto compatible, participable y hacer algo tremendamente solidario con todos nosotros. Pienso que el mensaje es un mensaje de solidaridad total con uno mismo y con los demás. Por eso os agradezco enormemente la presencia y bueno, y el que estéis aquí, porque sin estar ahí, él no estaría aquí tampoco. Así que muchas gracias y voy a dejar la palabra así.
Now I'm going to start my talk. I'm ready to listen.
Should I start with the bio
for
chat?
Okay. So before I start, I want to tell you a little bit story that I created here. Before this trip, Ricardo and Carlos, they worked together very hard.
Antes de este viaje, Ricardo y Carlos trabajaron juntos duramente.
Because someone like you is in a way straight, another way flexible, is difficult to handle.
Porque tratar con un hombre como él, que por un lado es flexible, por otro lado es estricto, pues a veces es difícil de llevar.
And I know they have very strong hearts to take me here and to share with all of you. First time I got an invitation letter from Ricardo, and at that time it was very hard because in our rules of monks, you have to stay 7 days. Only you have to go out of the monastery for 7 days when you are in a rainy retreat.
La primera vez que recibió la carta de invitación por parte de Ricardo estaba en un momento muy duro porque en su retiro él tiene que estar 7 días. Así, bueno, la norma que ellos tienen es que tiene que estar 7 días en.
¿Son 7 días?
Fuera.
So
de la estación de las lluvias.
Rainy retreat is for the month, particularly from July, August. July, August, September, up to October.
Eso lleva junio, julio, agosto, septiembre hasta octubre.
So this is especially forbidden the monks. If you're a monk, you cannot move from the same monastery. If you have any, probably people want to see you, listen to the teaching of the Buddha. If they invite you, you can go only for 7 days. You have to come back.
Durante esa época se reciben cualquier tipo de invitación, solo se pueden ir durante 7 días.
When I got the invitation letter from here first time, I said, this is only 7 days, impossible to take the flight 2 days gone, stay here 2 nights and 2 days.
So, era demasiado poco tiempo, ya solo el viaje, 2 días, estar aquí 2 días y luego volver otro viaje.
So I told him, please, it's impossible. Then he changed. Okay, 2014, we changed it. Then 2014, we tried to find a way of how we should do it, and they were together, and finally, this should happen in 1 month. And I don't want to see people uncomfortable. I don't want to impose people to be difficult and hard. This is my own will.
Su deseo es que nadie esté incómodo y nadie se sienta en dificultades ni más.
I just want to see everybody is comfortable, at ease, feeling happy. This is what I want to see.
Que estemos cómodos, confortables y de una manera fácil.
So when Ricardo told me this, Ricardo, do not worry. If you're really interested, you can come to my forest, stay as long as you want. If he wants to do this meditation, you can come to my forest,
que se recarga que iba a hacer la meditación, me dijo, pues venite a mi bosque y ahí te quedas todo el tiempo.
Because I don't want to look at everyone feeling hard, uncomfortable to do it. Finally, everything's done. Then I told him, okay, I will think every one of you like my family member, like my children. I think every one of you like my family member, like my children. And so I said here, a mother, you know already, a mother left even a pregnant baby before she gave a birth. So I feel like you all, before I see, you all are like a pregnant baby. So I am a mother. So the mother sees the baby when the baby is birth, she was so much happy. So when I see all of you, much more I feel love. So this is what I feel.
Okay?
This is the reason I'm not really usually traveling this way. I'm not used to traveling this way, but because of all of the hearts of the colors and colors, they want me to meet all the people here. And if I travel, my view is yeah, how hard it is for me. Because traveling and stuff, you know, just bring each other. So finally, you have to anyway go back to Sebastian again for 8 days. Tonight we will spend here. So out of all my love, I come here to meet and then also always I think what is good for you, I choose the topic how I should talk. So on the way, before I read here, and one of the topics comes to happen in my mind, that is the meaning of human being. So here my topic is the meaning of human being according to, of course, according to Buddhism. So according to Buddhism, human being is the only being very sharp-minded. Sharp-minded. It can grasp everything. It can learn everything. It can train everything. Okay. We all get this is the most important, very very important. Human being is the only being very sharp-minded.
Precise.
This human being can learn everything. This is the only being. No animal can do, no angel, no deity, no god can do such. Human being alone.
Los seres humanos pueden hacer algo que no hace ningún animal, ningún dios, o sea, pueden entenderlo todo de manera precisa y exacta.
So we say in Pali, I don't say this is very difficult to repeat in Pali, Mano Opsana, this is Pali. It means a sharp-minded being.
Mano Sala es la palabra que define esa inteligencia.
So you have to remember that you all are really sharp-minded beings. Don't think yourself less, but think much. You're a really great being. You can become an enlightened person anyway.
Todos vosotros no podéis olvidar que tenéis una
But we need anyway to reach here, Valencia. We need a good car, good driver. But also good help on the way. If I'm so often sick, I cannot travel. So like this, to get enlightened, to get a sharp-minded being, we need really training technique.
Okay,
there are three levels. First one is we have to try to be a meaningful human being, we have to try first to be a good human being.
Hay tres niveles. Y para llegar a alcanzar ese significado, lo primero que hay que hacer es ser un buen ser humano.
For being a good human being, there is a technique to practice kusala karma.
La técnica para llegar a ser buen ser humano es karma kusala.
Okay. Karma kusala means, karma means whatever you want perfect, it is karma.
Todo lo que quieras que sea perfecto es karma.
Kusala means action that has no disturbance, that has no actually disturbing yourself or other people.
Kusala es una acción que no moleste a otras personas.
There's two ways in that when you do this action. One way it can bring you happiness, and the other way is you don't disturb anyone.
Tiene como dos caras. Por un lado, ese tipo de acción te tiene que traer felicidad, y por otro lado, no tiene que molestar a otras personas.
So this is very, very important. Meaning to be first level of human being, to be a good human being, to practice kusala. Karma means whatever you wish best, perfect. Maybe you wish the best camera, you wish a good house, best house. These are karma, the meaning of karma. Karma means all the things the best. This is the meaning.
Karma es todo lo que puedas desear que sea mejor, por ejemplo, de querer una cama mejor o querer una casa mejor. Cualquier cosa que desees que sea mejor en tu vida es
karma. Karma is for external things, and kusala is internal action.
Karma se refiere a cosas externas, mientras que kusala a acciones
internas. So see, if a child wants a very best perfume, for example, you know, the cream for face to make beauty. That's a child, a girl, maybe.
A girl, okay.
So that beauty, that perfume, or that cream is karma.
Okay.
So, whenever a child is asking, please, can I get this cream for my face to make it beauty? It is karma.
Si cualquier niño pregunta si quiere esa crema para ser más bello.
Yes. If you really think, because I love the first time when I ordained as a monk, and we don't need a perfume, we don't need a makeup, we don't need a cream, we don't need... It's simple.
No quiero jugar, pero su vida es muy simple como monje, no necesitan ni perfumes, ni cremas.
Yeah, I live in a simple way. I love, but very much this way. Very simple and very, you know, cheap and less expensive in life. if you want to try, please come. Very simple and cheap life of, in this complicated world. Okay. And now you know karma is external. And kusala is internal.
Okay?
There are two words, kusala and akusala. Kusala is more beneficial, happier condition inside yourself.
Hay dos palabras, kusala.
Yeah. This is happier, more beneficial, and feeling joy, seeing those people are all
positive.
And akusala, the opposite. Akusala is feeling useless, feeling bad, is negative. For example, like we buy a cream, it is nobody like, it's another brand, and like I want to throw it away.
Akusala es lo contrario, sentirse triste, decepcionado con algo útil. Compras una crema, en el ejemplo de la crema, y no es la que te gusta y la.
I generally try to explain, and according to Buddhism, kusala, when you do karma kusala, you have to practice two things. One is generosity, try to share with everyone, like what we do now. And second one is moral quality, that two. The two are meaning of kusala, karma kusala, to be a good human being.
En el budismo, practicar el karma kusala requiere generosidad y moralidad.
Actually, generosity is called dana.
Generosidad es
dana. Morality is sila.
Moralidad es sila.
So it's very simple. Generosity, is, I often say you can start at home when you share your, at least your clothes, your food, your meal with your parents or grandparents, children. That is generosity anyway.
La generosidad se puede practicar en casa cuando compartes tus alimentos, tu ropa, tus cosas con la familia.
So there's one saying, and any charity begins at home. Everybody knows it. Charity begins at home.
Claro, la caridad empieza en tu propia casa.
So the first thing that generosity is according to Buddhism, how to practice to be a good human being. The meaning of a good human being is to practice generosity.
Para llegar a ser un buen ser humano hay que practicar la generosidad.
Actually, you can understand there's so many things are necessary for our life. We keep so many things because of our pleasure actually is not useful.
Tenemos muchas cosas en nuestra vida que realmente no son necesarias, las utilizamos para nuestro propio placer, pero no.
So when I practiced this meditation, I started actually when I was 22 years old boy.
Y empezó a meditar con 22 años, este tipo de meditación.
And I noticed so many unnecessary thoughts and emotions in my mind, and this meditation that I practice now, I will include this technique anyway. This meditation guides me how I should find what I need. So this meditation, actually the message of this meditation is how we should find what we really need for life.
¿Cómo podemos encontrar lo que realmente necesitamos en la vida?
So actually it makes us different between what we really need and what we want.
Hace la diferencia entre lo que necesitamos y lo que queremos.
Can you imagine how many things we want in the world? We need it very simple, very little, but we want so many entire universe.
Queremos muchas cosas, necesitamos muy poco, pero realmente queremos un universo.
Can you agree with me?
Yes.
Yes. So, you see, how we really want even the entire universe, it will never be ended. Our need is very simple, which makes us really happy.
Queremos tantas cosas que nunca conseguimos terminar con ellas, pero si realmente necesitamos algo muy simple.
Here, this meditation, this wisdom, this understanding is what I feel nice because it doesn't blame anyone, but we just have to advise them if we can do it.
Este tipo de meditación no culpabiliza a nadie y trata de hacer lo que
nosotros lo que tenemos. So it doesn't blame anyone.
No culpa a nadie.
So this meditation, first thing you have to think. To reach the first meaning of human being is you have to practice generosity and morality according to Buddhism.
El primer nivel es practicar generosidad y
morality. Morality is also very simple. In the Buddhism, only 5 for the people. For the monk, of course, 237 much more.
Para practicar la moralidad son 5 pasos.
And 5, okay. So this is not very serious, you can remember. I just tell you as knowledge. The first thing is don't kill.
No matar.
Second one, don't steal.
No robar.
I think nobody tries to kill. Nobody tries to steal. Mm-hmm. So you have already this morality.
Sí, okay. Nadie ha hecho esto, con lo cual ya tenemos esa parte de la
This manera. Is what nothing to do with the religion, but really what we have to do with our life, okay?
No tiene nada que ver con la religión, sino es algo que tiene que ver con.
I wrote one book, A Social Guide. I try to include these 5 precepts as economic point of view.
Si escribiera un libro, incluiría estos cinco preceptos desde el punto de vista económico.
Yeah, economic point of view, I just write in my book. And don't kill, don't steal, and don't, do you know adultery? Don't go over one husband or one wife.
No cometer adulterio.
It means you have to be faithful to each husband and wife forever. Don't break.
Ser fiel a la mujer o al marido de cada uno para siempre.
It's the third one. And the fourth one is no alcoholic drinking and drugs.
No beber alcohol ni drogas.
I think the majority of them are not doing this, huh? Some of you people are exceptional.
Sí, la mayoría de la gente no lo hace.
Okay. And
Don't lie. So don't try to lie, okay? Yeah? So I think you have already these kind of qualities, yeah? Then you have first level of human being, okay? To be a good human being. To do like it. You have these and you don't try to lie, you don't try to cheat, you don't try to hurt, sexual misconduct, you don't try to take intoxication, you don't lie. These things, you have, if you have this, you have this quality. And also, I think the entire world needs this five. I'm going to second level of human being, that to be a better human being.
El segundo nivel es ser un mejor ser humano.
So to be a human, to be a better human being, we need to practice samatha kusala.
Necesitamos practicar samatha kusala.
So this is very, very important. Can you repeat it?
Samatha kusala.
Can all of you repeat it?
Samatha kusala.
Samatha kusala.
Samatha
is concentrating, focusing on your own activity, whatever you do.
Samatha is concentrarse en cualquiera, que estás haciendo.
Including your cooking and business, everything.
Cualquier cosa,
cocinar, estar en un negocio. When you're really focusing on your own activity at the present moment, you will be a really successful person.
Si te concentras en tus actividades en el momento presente, puedes llegar a ser una persona.
So you can imagine how can you become a better human being.
Puedes llegar a ser un mejor ser humano.
So by practicing the samatha kusala.
Practicando
el samatha kusala. And meditation much deeper, because in a daily life, you have to just focus and concentrate on whatever you do. It includes even when you are going to the toilet. Because when you are going to the toilet, you pay attention to it, and you don't feel anything there, but you are at the moment. Otherwise, you sit down on the toilet, oh, well, where's my son? Where's what happens? So we're always out of us. So this is not helpful. You have to pay attention to everything that the meditation retreat is to try to train people to do it at all. This way. When you are in a retreat, much better, because you are a very close teacher, close advice, close in touch. You can do everything in the presence of the guidance.
The
retreat is not stressful because I have everyone like my family members. We are very, very open minded in the retreat. We're very happy. So, the second one, to be a better human being, don't forget. Samatha kusala, concentrating all activity you are doing.
Para ser una mejor persona, samatha kusala, concentrar todas las actividades diferentes.
So you can imagine how can you become successful, how can you become better by practicing this?
Puedes llegar a tener mucho éxito y llegar a ser mejor practicando simplemente esto.
This is actually not my own philosophy, but the philosophy of the Buddha. I have studied for 25 years and transmit it to you. Okay. So this is second level of how to become a better human being. Oh, you get it?
Yes.
Okay. I hope you will do it. And the third level is to be a perfect human being.
El tercer nivel ya sería como ser un ser humano perfecto.
You can see here how the Buddha and Buddhism and Buddhist philosophy views human life.
cómo el budismo ve la vida del ser humano.
This is great, I feel, because the Buddha himself is a human being. He married a girl, beautiful girl. He has a good son, a good nice son. And finally, he experienced all the things that he transmitted all to us again.
Buddha
is a human being, and he is a wife.
Fue también un ser humano, tuvo una mujer, hijos, familia, y al final fue cuando...
Finally, whatever he experienced, he transmitted all to us.
Una vez experimentado, lo transmite a todos.
You are just lucky because you found a monk who knows already those kind of things. If you have to learn from another one who has never been in the monastery, it will be difficult to understand.
Hemos tenido suerte de encontrar un monje que lo ha podido vivir y lo puede transmitir. Alguien que no haya estado en un monasterio sería más complicado.
So, to be hear what you have to see in the Buddha, how he values human being. Yes. He wanted us, all of us, to be a perfect being.
Buda valoraba el ser humano y quería que todos fuéramos perfectos seres humanos.
He doesn't theoretically inspire us, but he gave us a tool how to practice.
Él quería inspirarnos no solo teóricamente, sino darnos la posibilidad de practicar.
So here to how to practice to be a perfect human being, vipassana kusala.
Y la manera de practicarlo es vipassana kusala.
Can you repeat it?
Vipassana
kusala. Well done! So, vipassana kusala is now, it's related to the samatha kusala. Samatha kusala is training us how to focus, how to pay attention, how to concentrate on whatever we do.
Esto está relacionado con el nivel anterior, samatha kusala, la concentración, el focalizar la atención.
So the first I want to ask you, how many of you have you ever been experienced with so many things changes in a stressful life?
Yes. ¿Alguno de vosotros ha experimentado los cambios y la vida estresante?
Yes? So, this is the technique, how to heal, how to try to train us to be patient with those whole things changing in the world.
Esta es la técnica para tratar de sanar esto y tratar de calmar esta situación en la que vivimos en el mundo.
Whatever we think, whatever we feel, whatever things are outside, everything's changing and stuff.
Da igual como nos sintamos porque fuera todo está cambiando permanentemente.
This is the reason. First, you need to focus on yourself. You pay attention. You should pay attention to whatever you do. Sometimes it's unexpectedly broken, or maybe unexpectedly destroyed, or fall. Doesn't matter. It is the movement of change. If you understand this.
Tenemos que focalizarnos en nosotros mismos. Da igual que en un momento dado algo pueda romperse o cambiar.
So when you first train to understand, to focus on yourself, you're trying to keep your attention and then try to work on, and it's really anyway, sometimes we can face some fall. At that time, look at what we handle, how we should handle ourselves.
En un momento de estos en que todo cambia y nos preguntamos cómo podemos sobrellevar
this vipassana, the purpose of vipassana is to see things as they are, do not be involved, do not be attached to.
Esta técnica te permite ver las cosas como son, sin necesidad de estar apegado a ellas y demasiado involucrado.
So, when we are involved, when we are attached to a certain thing that we are working, when these things are changing, we feel really stressful. We don't know how to handle.
Cuando nos apegamos y nos involucramos mucho en las situaciones y estas cambian, nos producen mucho estrés.
Do you think any one of you is able to see such changing things in life?
¿Vosotros podéis pensar en situaciones de estas cambiantes en la vida?
Sí.
So I am included. I can see even the changing things in my life. This is the reason why I take this retreat and why I try to share this with people. This is the first strong reason.
Esta es una de las razones por las que él se retiró y por las que él trata de compartir esto con todo el mundo.
Because I came, I became a monk so late after my university when I was 24, I became a monk, and then I studied in a monastery for until now I'm teaching, guiding, and now it brings to you how nice it is.
Él se hizo monje tarde después de sus años de universidad, los 24 años, y estudió en el monasterio, y ahora da clases en el monasterio, y ahora puede compartir las enseñanzas.
Sí, first I was a man, and second a monk. Now I try to give you all you can do at home with this teaching.
Primero fue un hombre, luego monje, y ahora trata de dar a todo el mundo sus enseñanzas para que puedas practicarlas en casa.
You can imagine, without love and compassion, it cannot be done well.
Sin amor y sin compasión, no se puede hacer.
As I said, you all the baby are born. So, I feel really sharing, try to share with you everything I have.
Tal cual ha dicho antes, somos todos el bebé que ha dado a luz y que quiere compartirlo todo.
So here, we present my technique, my talk, and with meditation. And here in the vipassana meditation, the vipassana kusala, there are two different types. And the first one is the bhavana. This is kusala. Kusala is doing very much relaxed at home, not intensive. And bhavana is intensive in the retreat.
Hay dos tipos de meditación, de bhava que es más intensa y kusala que es menos intensa y más relajada.
Relax at home. You don't have any regular rules and regulations. You just go in a natural way.
En la relajada todo sale natural, no hay reglas, no hay normas.
It is similar like a nurse in the training school. She has to follow all rules and regulations to end the course. But when she goes with the patient, she is relaxed.
Es como una enfermera que en la universidad, en la escuela, tiene que seguir todas las reglas y cuando ya tiene los estudios terminados y ya trabaja con el paciente, se puede relajar.
So I think everybody realizes because when you are in a training course, you have to work hard a little bit.
Cuando estás en un curso de entrenamiento, necesitas trabajar más.
And when we come back to daily life, we feel relaxed.
Y en la vida diaria, te puedes relajar.
We don't need to follow so much rules and regulations like in a training course.
No necesitas seguir tantas normas.
So here, vipassana kusala, vipassana bhavana is different. Vipassana bhavana is particularly referring to the training course of meditation.
El vipassana bhavana es para los cursos de entrenamiento más intensivo y vipassana kusala es
más. Vipassana kusala is at home, whatever you do.
En vuestras casas.
Particularly, it is a kind of wisdom that makes us develop within us when we have some problems in life, unacceptable.
Es un tipo de sabiduría que desarrollamos cuando tenemos un problema en la vida.
Because sometimes, we have some problems. Because the purpose of the person is seeing things as they are. It means if it's good, try to see it as good. If it is bad, try to see it as bad. Don't be involved.
Es tratar de ver las cosas tal y como son. Si son buenas, son buenas, y si son malas, son malas.
Sin
estar involucrado, sin apegarse a ellas.
Because we are very easy to be involved, very easy to be attached to. It makes us simply suffer when we are involved too much, when we are attached too much.
Fácilmente nos involucramos y nos apegamos a las situaciones y eso hace sufrir.
It is nothing wrong because we are human beings. I am attached to the world.
No es algo equivocado, somos seres humanos y lo hacemos normalmente también.
Because the world is so quiet when first time I was there, and the sea and the nature and all of that, I love very much.
He's attached to the world.
Está bueno, sí.
So, this attachment is not wrong, but when we are attached to, when we are involved, how can we do it? This is the technique.
No es malo estar apegado y estar involucrado, pero ¿cómo lo hacemos cuando esto ocurre?
Then we have to think, oh, things are changing, I don't need to be attached to. Okay, of course, I'd be attached to it, it doesn't matter, I have to handle this.
nos encontramos involucrados, ¿cómo lo podemos manejar?
So it means to see things as they are, to see as it is, to see as it is, as it is. It makes us feel nice.
Ver las cosas tal y como son. Y de esa manera te sientes mejor.
Probably a girl may be attached to a boy, maybe a boy attached to a girl.
A veces una persona se siente una chica se siente más apegada a un chico y el chico se siente apegado a esa chica.
When we are broken in relation, they will feel probably suffer.
Y cuando la relación se rompe, lo más seguro es que sufran.
Why we are suffering? Because we change our mind. The girl changed the girl's mind. The boys change the boy's mind.
Y eso es que se ha producido un cambio. El chico ha cambiado respecto a la chica o la chica respecto.
So if we are not thinking that change is nature, we will feel really bad. We don't know how to handle it. Some people are almost taking suicide for those kind of change. They can't stay.
Si no pensamos que cambios así son naturales, la gente sufre mucho. Puedes llegar al suicidio por una situación así.
So at that moment we can think, oh, it's a change. It's nature, okay? When these things are changing, you have to just let it go. That's the way to do.
La manera de pensarlo, esto es natural, es la naturaleza y simplemente dejarlo pasar.
This is vipassana kusala, the two kinds, vipassana bhavana, vipassana kusala. Vipassana is very relaxed at home. Vipassana bhavana is like in a training course.
Y esto es el vipassana kusala, que si es relajado en casa es kusala y cuando es en la escuela es
bhavana. So my problem is too attached to my mother, Jack. This is the serious problem, this is the awakening. Because of this, I took this retreat. How to understand this attachment?
Él se sintió muy involucrado en la muerte de su madre y eso hizo que decidiera retirarse para poder entenderlo.
Can I ask you, is there anyone who has never been suffered such attachment?
¿Hay alguien que nunca haya sentido una involucración de esta manera?
Yes or no?
Yes.
So we are in touch, no? We are very much in touch with this teaching.
The
monk, Buddhist monk, fisherman, everyone can be attached to it. If they don't know how to handle the problem, I don't think it's something.
Todo el mundo se involucra y se siente apegado a las situaciones y el tema
es
saber cómo manejar.
This is the only way that trains us how to become a perfect being, perfect human being. If you're a man, to be a perfect man. If you're a man, you to be a perfect man. If you're a boy, you have to be a perfect boy. By practicing this.
Esta es la única enseñanza que nos permite ser un ser humano perfecto, un hombre o una mujer perfecto practicando estas enseñanzas.
Well, yeah, there's nothing to do with your faith, your belief, your God. Doesn't matter. It doesn't bother anyone. Its gift is only how to handle those kind of emotional problems within us.
Da igual quién sea, si te enseña simplemente a saber manejar estas situaciones.
Okay, so this is a technique. If even everyone, if they feel suffer for something else, for attachment, they can do it. This technique is like a tool or medicine.
Esta herramienta, es una herramienta, es una medicina que sirve para curar en los casos de sufrimiento cuando te sientes muy apegado a una situación.
So I'm a such very good example of my mother because I attached so much to my mother when she died when I was a little boy and I felt so much suffering for this.
Ejemplo de su madre porque se sintió muy apegado a esta situación y me metió en esta situación porque murió cuando tenía 8 años.
So finally I know how to handle it, how to let it go, how to deal with it, then I knew and I can live perfectly.
Y ha conseguido entenderlo, ha conseguido dejar pasar la situación y vivir con ello.
Yeah, I'm honest, I am almost attached to all of you because you are really nice.
Y se siente muy apegado a todos vosotros porque sois.
So attachment, no, I have to handle. I will go back to my country with this attachment. Doesn't matter.
El sentirse apegado no es malo. De volver a su país con este sentimiento y no es malo.
So this is how we have to go. This, way of life and how we have to train ourselves how to live perfectly. How to live perfectly.
Te enseñan eso, a cómo vivir en perfección.
how to handle each other, how to help each other as long as we are alive. See, here the nationality, the country, the places are different. But the problems are different. It's all the same.
Aquí es otro país, otra nacionalidad, otra cultura, pero los problemas son iguales.
There are so many things we should be attached to, but if we don't know, we will suffer, we will really suffer.
Hay muchas cosas a las que nos apegamos, y si no sabemos que lo estamos haciendo, sufriremos.
Here what we should be careful is, we are not trying to blame attachment or the one who is attached, but we are trying to give a tool on to handle it.
No hay que culpabilizar a nadie, ni a la situación, ni a la persona, pero lo que hay que hacer es utilizar la herramienta.
So we can blame anyone when someone is attached. We can blame them. We can try to share when someone is feeling suffering from attachment. Please do it. Please do it. And I will be with you. Okay.
No se puede culpabilizar a nadie cuando la situación se plantea, sino simplemente ayudar y darle la herramienta para que lo pueda resolver.
So if you take this kind of quote and tweet, you will understand much more. And I just want to end my talk now. It's there's only different vipassana bhavana and vipassana kusana. Vipassana bhavana is deeply focusing on the training goals of vipassana meditation. And vipassana kusana is doing it well after your training point.
Todo esto se puede entender mucho mejor en un retiro. En un retiro se practicaría el vipassana bhavana, que es mucho más focalizado, mucho más teórico, con más reglas, y posteriormente en casa, más relajado, el vipassana
So to end, to be a good being, good human being, we have to practice generosity, morality, according to Buddhist approach.
Para ser un buen ser humano, lo primero es practicar la generosidad y la moralidad según lo que nos indicó Buda.
So to be a better human being, we have to practice samatha kusala.
Para ser un mejor ser humano, practicar el samatha kusala.
So focusing on daily activity, whatever you do.
Focalizándonos en nuestra actividad diaria, hagamos lo que hagamos.
So to be a perfect human being, we have to practice vipassana.
Y ya para ser un ser humano perfecto hay que practicar vipassana.
So now we are going to take a silent meditation for 15 minutes together.
Vamos a hacer una meditación de 15 minutos juntos.
So you have very good position of sitting. Or just can sit down in the chair, doesn't matter. You can just, I want you here in present space.
Puede estar sentados en la silla y lo hará desde aquí para respetar el espacio.
So, and first is the back in the most important. You have to keep straight like 90 degrees.
Hay que mantener la espalda derecha 90 grados.
Which means you are really doing.
Estás haciendo lo que significa que estás en
su. And second, actually, you know, this is really right way. You have to sit cross-legged. You have to make the lower part of the body flat. Because if you do it flat, you can keep the balance of the back.
Because
so of the spaces, where you can move it now on the chair and sit down and keep the back straight and close the eyes softly. And here, closing your eyes, keeping the back straight, keeping the lower part of the body flat. These three things are already important for meditation.
Lo más importante, los ojos, la espalda derecha y la parte baja del cuerpo plana.
This is also when you are doing a sitting meditation, but not only sitting is meditation, but there is also walking, standing, different positions.
Esto para la meditación sentado, pero hay más tipos de meditaciones, incluso andando.
Because most of the people, when you say meditating, you see sitting picture at all.
Normalmente cuando vimos hablar de meditación, pensamos en una posición sentada.
So here, keeping the eyes closed, keeping the back straight, keeping the back flat, the lower body flat. These things are important for someone who is sitting in meditation.
Lo más importante para una posición sentada, ojos cerrados, espalda derecha.
Yeah, the question of the hand. I met
one woman from Holland or Sweden, somewhere else, in which she came to teach. She's used to meditating, and she asked me the hand position. And she's very much arguing with me. I don't know the position, but you don't have this position. You can be relaxed. Your hand should be relaxed on the knees, on the thighs, or you should be relaxed with the hand. Don't be busy with the hand.
En cuanto a la posición de las manos, simplemente dejarlas relajadas, no tenerlas en movimiento ni trabajando.
We are already busy with the three things. If we have to be busy with the hand, I think we cannot meditate.
Ya tenemos tres cosas en las que estamos ocupados y movimos las manos ya no.
When this woman's arguing with the hand position on the knee, I don't know this idea. I told her, if the hand is so much important, if someone should cut the hand, how can you meditate then?
Y conocí una mujer que estaba muy preocupada por la posición de las manos y al final le dijo que si era tan importante si le cortaran las manos, que cómo podría,
and she stopped, she stopped arguing with me.
Y ya no discutió más.
You're right.
Le dijo, tienes razón.
So hand should be relaxed, okay?
Mano relajada.
You relax, you should feel that your hand is comfortable.
Confortable.
Now we're going to be in silence for 15 minutes. We'll ring the bell. Just pay attention to the breath. If the breath is simply between the lips and the nose, there's no other place for the breath. Between the lips and the nose, it comes in, goes out, comes in, goes out. We just first pay attention to the breath.
Primero prestar atención a la respiración entre la nariz y los labios, entra y sale, entra y sale.
That's what I want to remind you again. This, don't think it's less. It is really important. Nowadays, many scientists found this evidence that mindfulness, attention, the relation between the brain and heart, they found it. When you pay attention to the breath very closely, brain and heart function very well.
Si prestáis atención a la respiración, se da la atención plena y la unión entre el cerebro y la respiración.
You can imagine how when brain and heart function very correctly, you can be really healthy. Here, the Carlos is a doctor, he's been asking.
El cerebro y el corazón. Prestando la atención a la respiración, se llega a la unión entre el cerebro y el corazón.
Just breathing between the nose and the lip, okay? And pay attention to the breathing in and out, and that's all. And keep practicing in and out.
Prestar atención a cómo entra y sale la respiración entre la nariz y los labios.
Pueda esta meditación darnos paz y felicidad. Que pueda esta meditación darnos paz y felicidad. Que pueda esta meditación darnos paz y felicidad.
Salud.
Salud.
Well done.
Yeah.
So, this is the conference here, and is there anyone who wants to ask questions or answer? Or if you want to come with us directly to San Francisco, San Sebastián. Particularly, I experience in my country, the children are not much more interested in my country because of this kind of complicated world. They don't want to come out and they are looking for something else to help them.
Con niños de nuestro país que por la situación tan complicada que tienen, pues están tratando de buscar un mundo mejor, pero creo que la situación que te planteabas no tiene sentido.
Lo planteo por
cómo
personalmente mis enganches y mis juicios.
Lucky because in Burma, military ruling systems kept the country for a long time. We cannot come out without teaching. Now we can come out and share with the whole world. This is really lucky.
Pero ahora tenemos suerte porque hasta ahora en su país no dejaban salir a los monjes a dar estas enseñanzas, por eso se había mantenido internamente, pero ahora ya pueden expandir el conocimiento.
Politics is so stupid, I'm not interested in politics anyway. Because of this, now we are traveling. I can travel. Because in 2004, I was once invited to attend to the ceremony of the conversion of Buddhism in India. But at the time, so much difficult to travel. They asked so many questions. What is the reason? Where you want to go? Where is the place to go? What are you doing there? So many questions.
Él no le gusta hablar de política ni de políticos. No le gustan, pero... Antes era más difícil viajar, en 2004 le invitaron a la India y le preguntaron tantísimas cosas y tantos requisitos que finalmente no.
Well, this time when I came out of my country, nobody checks. And the police at the airport come, what can I help you? Nothing.
Y ahora salió de su país, nadie le ha preguntado nada y la policía en el aeropuerto simplemente le preguntaron cómo podían ayudarle.
We are just lucky, you know, because this teaching can come out, share with everyone. This is, I think, really preserved, purely preserved in the country.
La enseñanza vipassana se ha mantenido preservada en su país, pero ahora ya pueden salir a
enseñar. I meet many people living in this country, and so many people come to practice with me. They included fellows and Ricardo. They came to me to practice, but just little, and they invited me to come. Now we can do it together.
Mucha gente iba al país a practicar allí con él, incluidos Carlos y Ricardo, y ahora él ya puede venir aquí a enseñar.
It is something wonderful because I spent for 25 years long there and studied a lot, teaching, practice, and now I can share with you. How nice.
Ha esperado por 25 años, ha practicado, ha estudiado, y ahora puede compartir.
Any question?
Yes. According to Buddhism, what is it? When we as human beings can follow these 5 points you mentioned?
I think if we need will, we need will, if we want to do it, everything can be done.
Okay.
First, we want to do it because, for example, like to myself, I dream a lot to stay in the forest, very reluctant sometimes, but finally I did it, it's okay now. Already 10 years in the forest of my own.
Le preguntaba que, según el budismo, ¿qué pasa si como terceros humanos no podemos salir de esas cinco, esos cinco puntos en un lado de no matar, no robar, sufrir con nuestra pareja, no beber alcohol, ni tomar drogas, sino
So there's a saying, nothing is impossible to a willing heart.
Nada es imposible para un corazón que lo desea.
So when you're really willing, you can do everything well.
Si lo deseas, puedes hacer cualquier cosa.
This trip, for example, I told them, I have never used to travel in this world, so far from one place to another, but I try to patiently do for all of you.
Este viaje, por ejemplo, nunca había hecho nada similar y finalmente lo he hecho.
So, when you're really willing, everything can be done.
Cuando tienes el deseo, cualquier cosa
puede conseguirse. Okay, then I hope you all get it. Some people are moving now, we should...
Pues yo os pido, espera un momentito hasta que salga él. Hasta que salga para acabar todos juntos. Y despedirnos bien, porque si no empieza un trasiego, como bien lo sabemos. O sea, con esto, quizás ahí os esperan. Sí.
Mi pregunta sería, cuando se ha acabado la meditación, habéis hecho una pequeña plegaria en la cual se posponía el gozo del presente de la meditación. No he entendido.
Oye. This is a kind of energy, this meditation, this is not like a praying, but try to concentrate again to lead us to that peace and happiness we want to reach.
Es una manera de volverse a concentrar otra vez para llegar a alcanzar esa paz y esa felicidad. No es como rogar o una plegaria, es una concentración.
It's not a formal prayer, but I try to create here because just to, we want to reach that peace and happiness, may this meditation lead us to just to concentrate, bring the tension as soon as we finish, but otherwise we are going.
Claro, después de la meditación, la cabeza se va y él ha tratado de atraerlo todo a este deseo de paz y felicidad, concentrar ahí ese deseo, no como una plegaria, sino como concentración.
Lo bonito de esa concentración es la permanencia en ella. No en la posposición futurible.
Yeah, you're right. So, if there's no question, we just want to do, and we should be still here. Okay?
Bueno, lo primero es agradeceros a todos vuestra presencia, a Antonio. Thank you.